say that we are live and dangerous here at Studio 10, and over our 1,000 episodes, we have managed to pull off some pretty amazing stunts right in front of your very eyes. And Richard Reid is here to take us through some of the most memorable.
Your loaves. I mean, it was, I gotta tell you, the very first episode, you guys did not waste any time. There was something called Operation Ita.
It was being careful.
Okay, all right. You guys didn't waste any time. You got right to it. These are like must-see moments that you really can't script. You don't even plan these things. All right. Trapped at the high seas in a broken water taxi, our Australian of the year. She turned lemons into lemonade, as usual. Take a look.
Let's just stop talking and just try to survive this.
I am off middle head, and my engine has failed. Over.
Oh, no way, you're kidding me. But how does the boat just stop? The guy just said that the boat's broken down and he's got full tanks of fuel, but we're basically just floating in George's head.
A harrowing 42 minutes stranded at sea. And if it wasn't for the kindness of a passing ferry, we might still be there now.
Oh, goodness me, I'd have saved.
Operation Ita was back in business. Another satisfied customer. Mission accomplished.
Do you remember, I was trying to get from Manly where we were doing Wake Up, I'd done Wake Up, our previous show, and we were on our way to Piedmont when the launch conveniently broke down. I still think the executive producer of this show had something to do with it. And we rocked around there, and in the middle of the heads, it was terrible. And when I got here, wet, bedraggled like a dog, he said, oh, quickly, on the set. The executive producer, on the set. I said, I've got to change, I'm wet. He said, oh, but it was such good television. Mamma mia.
And instead, you made international headlines.
So funny. And now our Robbo is up for almost anything. Mm. And he did a very dangerous stunt right outside the offices here at Channel 10.
Oh, my gosh. This was nail-biting.
Yeah. Yeah. Okay.
It really was something of a shock that who knew under that sweet, soft demeanor lay the body of a superhero, right? Yeah. Okay, so he's decked out in body-hugging spandex. Robbo threw caution to the wind, maybe even his clothing. All right, he abseiled down the side of this very building. Take it out.
2 and 3, here we go.
Oh my gosh!
Be careful. Go, Robbo, you're doing well, mate. Just one step at a time.
Okay.
It's all safe.
I've got him open. Okay. Oh, yeah, okay.
Well done.
Okay.
Keep going, that's it.
Well, this is just a walk in the park. Open the hands. Oh my god, that harness, it hugs every part of you. There wasn't that much to hug first, but now there's nothing there. Okay. Okay. Open the hands, guys. Well, that was masculine. Okay, great. That'll dispel those rumours.
Okay. How are those spidey senses going for you?
Oh, they're going pretty... Oh, this harness. Okay, it's getting offensive. Oh. Bend my knees and jump out. No, I can't do it.
He's never really talked quite the same ever since.
He's a brave man.
Braver than me.
And also, we put a spinning wheel in control of the show at one stage.
Oh, my gosh. I was here for that day. Okay, now you know if anyone knows. The TV is, you know, basically live TV, controlled chaos.
Yes,
Okay, but when you leave the fate of the show, what segment is coming where? Up to a giant spinning wheel. Remember that? I was like, this went here. It was crazy. It was practically pandemonium.
This could be the day that ends it all. Let's find out what the first bit of today's show will be. Oh. Ready? We're spinning the wheel!
This is exciting. What are we going to do? Here we go. Oh, the anticipation. I'm going to say that's Friday the 13th.
Oh! Where's our Melbourne guests? We need the couch in, boys. Let's go. Can you guys run on to the home? We'll wait for the guests. Wait for the couch.
Actually, what happens in the ad breaks every day? You don't see the amazing workout studio crew do. They pull this desk in
they
and out.
They go faster, though.
That's right.
Bloody hell.
Right, let's put the goblin. All right.
You're exactly right, Sarah.
Scotty, what are you doing now, mate?
I just put the couch in. Oh,
okay, right. And is there any particular way you do with this?
Oh, it's all marked. It's all because of the lights and everything.
Yep. Oh, Scotty, you answered that question seriously. That's very good. All right.
Careful, you
almost there. We've got Denise and Jess on the desk here. Oh, bend with the knees. Bend with the knees. Oh! No. Bend with the knees. That's all right. Now, this is, as Sarah mentioned, what you normally see, what you don't see during the commercial breaks.
In defence of the wheel, I think at one point, 10 management thought, well, it's cheaper than an EP.
We don't have to give the wheel a car parking spot. I was actually standing there going, this is the dumbest idea I have ever seen. But it actually worked. It was anyway. Now, another thing, Richard, we also take things very, very seriously on the show. And last Halloween, we wanted to set a genuine, not just TV, a real life, real world Guinness World record. Oh. And by golly, we did.
Oh, my, you guys don't mess around, especially when it comes to Halloween and dress up time. This had to be one of the happiest yet ghoulish moments ever on Studio 10. Our very own Sarah Harris, dressed up as Wednesday from the Addams Family. She set a new world record for smashing 12 pumpkins in just 60 seconds. Check out this tanty.
Go.
That's it. Two. Go,
go, go! Go, give it a
Wednesday!
Go, go! Go, go! Go! Seven, eight, nine.
I feel full of rage.
Ten.
There we go. Wow.
Ten.
Come on, come on.
Go. That's 11. This is a 12.
Go.
That was really someone from the Guinness Book of Records, an official record watcher, who ticked it off, and that record stood for 24 hours.
Yeah. Oh.
until someone from a UK morning show, Robbie Williams' wife from, I think, Loose Women, the TV show in the UK, saw it and took us on. So there was an actual, a global fight.
My husband Tom saw that and he said he didn't know whether to be terrified or impressed.
And we did a live hypnotism stunt with Peter Powers. Remember that?
Yes.
And he managed to get Jess in a trance.
He did. Yes.
Yeah.
It was so relaxing.
It was fantastic.
That's the thing. Okay. One of the reasons everyone loves this show, and I said before, is everyone is so real, and you're real all the time. Yet, when that stunt happened, viewers were like, what? We're not sure about this. Okay, check it out. Check it out.
Snuggle up to him purring. Makes you feel very content. Want to see your wide awake? Wake up. We've got a dog back here. So. Now, I'm going to command them all because I think they're all capable of doing. Sit up straight. Sit up straight.
Oh my dude.
And now bed.
Oh my gosh. Okay. Remember, there were emails, there were articles written, there were tweets. People were saying, oh, come on, you can't fool us. We love this show, but it's an all-time new low. Wow. What? Okay, tell us. Were you hypnotized?
Yeah, it's fantastic. Yeah. It's like you're so calm and you're almost meditating. So yeah. You're aware of what's happening, but you don't care. It's fantastic.
Mm. Yeah. But you've done it before. You've done it before. Yeah. You were hypnotized once before and you had the plumbing thing.
That's right.
And you thought it was a Logie.
I won a Logie. Yep.
Go, but full disclosure. So what happens before a hypnosis thing is the hypnotist will actually come on the show and see if you're a suitable candidate for hypnosis. So it'll take a bunch of people backstage before the show.
Meaning us.
And one day it was the three of us. It was Denise and me and Jess. And the hypnotist goes to Denise, goes, nah, goes to me, goes, nah, and goes to Jess and goes, oh, hello.
Reid, love you.
Oh, thank you.